Hello everyone, welcome to the online lecture of Vehicle Testing and Homologation. I am Milan Trivedi, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today we are going to discuss with the very important and very interesting chapter of VTH, that is Active and Passive Safety System. First of all, we will understand the definition of Active and Passive Safety System. Then we are elaborately discuss about the different basic safety systems and the advanced safety system. That has been very interesting part. So let us understand the different safety system of the automobile. If we categorize the safety system of the automobile, it has been categorized under two categories, active one and the passive one. Active safety system is that safety system which is assisting in the prevention of the crash. This will try to just prevent the accident. That all the safety system present in the automobile is categorized under active safety system. And the passive is that which helps to protect the occupant during a crash. Now the accident has happened, but it will try to just reduce the damage which has been happening out due to the accident. So the role of the active safety system is for the hazard detection, hazard avoidance and the hazard mitigation part. And the role of the passive safety system, the red zone is indicating that the crash has been happened, but it will try to reduce the damage which is coming out due to the accident part. So we are having these two different types of safety system in the automobile. Now let us just elaborate the active safety system part in our today's lecture, and we will continue with the passive safety system in the next lecture. Talking about this particular active safety system, it is also called as a crash avoidance system. Now we are going to first of all understand the basic crash avoidance system in our automobile that is required to be there in almost inch of the car in order to just pass the homologation norms. The first one is a headlamps and the reflectors. Now this is a very basic part. Whenever you are traveling across a night region or in the night travel, we need to have a proper illumination. For that the headlamp is must required, right? Traffic police can stop you if only one light is working on, right? Because that is coming again in a mandatory part. So apart from that, the reflector surface from which the light is falling off on the ground surface, that should be in a very proper way. So the first one is a headlamps and the reflector part. The second system is other lights and the signals. Whenever suppose if you are taking a turn, the parking brake lights, the fog lamps, all these are categorized under the different lights conditions. But again, this is very much required. All the fog lamp is does not categorize under the mandatory requirement, but yes, that is coming under this section of the crash avoidance system. If it is working in a proper way, you can almost eliminate number of accident. The third one is the vehicle mirrors, right? We are having three mirrors mandatory nowadays. Initially only once, that is a central mirror was required, later on the right side driving side mirror was there, but nowadays even left side mirror is even a part of a mandatory safety system. So this is about the vehicle mirror part. The fourth one is a vehicle braking system. Yes, we normally we are taking a braking system or study that thing under a separate category, but this braking system is coming under the safety system part. If it's not working, okay, obviously you can face the accident. The fifth one, that is a vehicle steering system, that should be also working in a proper way. If it is leading to the understeer oversteer condition, then also it can lead to the condition of accident, right? Apart from that, if it is somewhat related to the wheel alignment part also, if it is not coming in its original position, then also it can lead to the condition of accident. The sixth one basic is the vehicle suspension system, right? This like again a brake system we study separately, but yes, it also categorized under the particular crash avoidance system. If the suspensions are working in a proper way, then we can mitigate number of accident. Now let us understand that different advanced active safety system, which has been very much important in a current scenario, because lot of car manufacturers are giving competition by just implementing the advanced active safety systems. The seventh one or the first one under this active advanced active safety system as a driver alertness detection system. In abbreviation form, we are also calling it as a DADS. This is that system which will give certain signal to the driver if he is feeling or he is not getting alert in driving. In the night travel, most of the time it happens, or if the driver is traveling for a longer period of hours, then he may feel the kind of scenario in which his pupil will try to fall down. He might feel sleepiness during travel conditions. So that can even lead to the accident. So under such scenario, there would be certain sensor which will just detect the retina portion of the driver, and it will start raising the alarm, or it may even give you certain other signals through which the driver get alert. So that is the DADS system. The eighth one, that is the automatic braking system. This is actually a boon to the driver, because some of the time it may happen that you does not notice the particular obstruction which is coming across to you. So in such scenarios, so say for example, if this particular truck is traveling, but yes, he is not noting the small vehicle across his path. So in such scenario, the vehicle will take a judgment by its own, by the front certain sensors, right? That sensors will give feedback to the braking system, and the brake would be applied automatically, and you can almost avoid the particular accident. The ninth one, that is the infrared night vision system. Normally, this kind of system would be required in such vehicle which travels in off-road conditions, or the military vehicles, which is actually required to be taken at the different terrains, or that is also required to be done in a dark night operations. So under such scenario, just to widen out the vision, we are having this kind of infrared night vision system. You might have heard about the infrared cameras also, which is having a tendency to look towards a very, very far region object, right? So such application would be there in this kind of vehicle. Normally, from this particular diagram also, a lot of things are very clear, that this yellow portion, that is a normal span of the particular lamp. But if we implement this infrared night vision system, we look towards this particular span of the light, almost a lot of visibility would be there due to the implementation of infrared night vision systems. The 10th one, that is the adaptive headlamps. Now, the one problem which most of the car are facing is that whenever we are taking a turn, the light will still try to go on a straight path, right? So you might miss some of the object which is either on extreme left or on the extreme right, based on the condition on which you are taking a turn. Under such scenario, we can have this kind of adaptive headlamps, in which the reflector portion would be rotating on based on that, and in some of the case even lamps are also changing the position. So based on that, you can have a proper view. See the first scenario, that is the standard headlamps, and in the case of the adaptive headlamps, look towards the visibility part. It just increases the visibility, and you won't miss out this particular object. This is the object which can be missed out under the standard headlamps, while in the adaptive headlamps, this is visible, right? So this is the advantage of the adaptive headlamps. 11th, that is a reverse backup sensor. Now, that has been coming in almost most of the car nowadays, and almost it has been nowadays mandatory part to give up the backup sensors. Backup sensors are of many types, but normally proximity sensor is mandatory, that it will start giving you signals in the form of alarm whenever you are taking reverse. 12th, that is back camera. This is actually more accurate to in comparison to just parking sensors, because just parking reverse brake parking sensors are the alarms raising tank of sensor, just that will give you the alarm. But here you can physically view the particular object whenever you are taking a reverse turn. The 13th one, that is adaptive cruise control. Right, you can set the vehicle in a cruise control mode. It will take over the command. It will have proper lane travel. So that is the advantage of the adaptive cruise control. 14th one, that is the lane departure warning. See, some of the time if you are traveling in a very very straight path at a constant speed, but suddenly if you feel slippiness, then it might have happened that you will change the lane. So as soon as the vehicle is starting getting deviated from its single lane path, it will start raising the alarm, right? So that is a lane departure warning type of sensors. 15, that is a tire pressure monitoring system. This is very much required in a heavy vehicles, right? Some of the time it may happen that underinflated, overinflated tire condition, when it's burst out, it can lead to a major accident. So in order to prevent that scenario, we are keeping this kind of tire pressure monitoring system under our this pulpit part of the driver cabin, right? In which it will indicate the different pressures of different tires. The 16th, that is a traction control system. This can prevent the particular rollover condition. Here fishhook type of test has been carried out, and it will just prevent the traction or it will have a better control over the traction part of the vehicle. 17th is the electronic stabilatory control. If sudden obstruction is coming towards the path of the vehicle, then we need to steer very fast. Under such scenario, we may face a rollover condition. We are driving at very high speed, sudden some obstruction is coming out. We just try to need to steer out the vehicle. So in such scenario, the electronic stability control will keep the vehicle in a stable condition. 18th one, that is the ABS, anti-lock braking system. This is again very common nowadays. Here, instead of locking of the vehicle, it will set the vehicle free. So under such scenario, a vehicle can escape very easily, right? It will apply brake in a such a pattern that it will apply a brake, it will release a brake, right? That is a detailed part which we can discuss in a later segment, but ABS is actually coming under the advanced part. The another one is the electronic brake force distribution. Some of the times it may happen whenever we are using this kind of hydraulic braking system, almost equal amount of force is getting towards all the four wheels, right? But if there is certain distribution, whenever we need to even steer the vehicle, whenever you are using ABS, we need to steer the vehicle and we are applying. So under such scenario, it can produce a disturbance in this particular stability of the vehicle. Under such scenario, EBD, that will particular detect how much force is required in the different wheels. According to that, the brake force distribution would be there. Nowadays, even most of the cars are giving this EBD, that is electronic brake force distribution. And the last one we will take under this category is the automated parking brake, right? Some of the time this kind of accident may happen that you come out from the car, you forgot to apply the parking brake, and certain slope is present, then the vehicle would be dragged towards that particular slope and you may have come across a major loss. So under such scenario, this kind of brake would be very much helpful, that as soon as you stop the vehicle, the parking brake would be applied, right? So that's all about the different advanced active safety system. Thanks for watching.